think of nooks and crannies and the mind might travel to skinny urban alleyways or twisting backwoods roads.
But a long straight highway, speed limit 55, completely impervious to a cozy little nook, right? Well, you might want to tap the brakes a little bit.
One is planted out here in apple country.
You are at the Johnny Appleseed Visitor Center. We are between exits 34 and 35 on Route 2 in Lancaster.
That's right, a rest stop on Route 2 is, against all expectations, entirely nook-worthy.
It's not your average sterile-looking facility. You will not find another one like this. I hear it all the time. They travel the country. These truckers are in awe of the place, and they keep coming back.
The Johnny Appleseed Visitor Center, named for Lemonster's local boy made good, John Chapman, or Johnny Appleseed. Here, the visitor can find a display of historical artifacts. There are hand-painted murals of the four seasons in apple country, and the shelves are stocked with local honeys, jams, and fresh baked goods.
It's very, very beautiful, and it's decorated in a nice country setting. There's definitely a nice home charm to it.
It might be the only rest stop with a fan club, making this way station an end in itself. Reagan O'Reilly Miller of Rhode Island.
It almost has like a country crock home setting, like a little antique store, if I may say that.
The Johnny Appleseed Visitors Center is operated by the North Central Massachusetts Chamber of Commerce. If the place has a personal touch, it might just be traced back to manager Diane Burnett.
I was once told I run it like it's my own store. Maybe.
With the onset of fall, there are free apples for every visitor.
Last year we went through 87 cases of apples. We polish them every day. The basket is always full.
The Johnny Appleseed Visitor Center, a rest stop that's hard to resist.
You hear it 5-6 times a day. I never knew this was here. Don't just sit by at 65, stop in. Come and say hi. Come and grab the soda, the jam, the jelly, the local made cookies. I mean, I have local cookies that are plate size. Come on. Come in and sample and see what there is to offer here in North Central Mass.
Back in the city, that staple of urban life, the corner store or bodega, paper towels, cereals, and snacks, but all is not quite what it seems.
Everything we do has a bit of subversion in it.
You see, somewhere in this bodega is a secret door, one that we have agreed not to reveal.
All of a sudden, if you find a secret passage, you'll find the rest of the story.
In the hidden back room, a carefully curated emporium of street cool, sneakers, clothing, art, and accessories.
It's not that much of a secret anymore. Still every day, about half the people who walk in here have their minds blown, yeah.
Oliver Mack is co-founder of Bodega, perhaps the ultimate urban nook and cranny. Oh, and by the way, the store out front is fully functional for those who want to pick up some canned beans with their new kicks.
I think there's confusion, but there's also when the door opens and people see what they're getting into, there's this moment of illumination and there's this spark of imagination that comes over people's minds and they begin to understand that everything in the city is not what it seems and there's things hidden in every corner.
And there is a Bodega West in downtown Los Angeles now that has a secret location and already has a cult following. Very hip.
And you do not need a special secret word to get it. You just go find those people with the cool sunglasses on and they will be happy to point you to the secret passageway.
Still to come, an abandoned quarry rocks on.
Today, the quarry is home to Ean Sculptures and Victor's ingenious sound machines.